Friends, hope you're all doing well, and I believe you must have gone through the last video, and this is of her fifth video of the same chapter. And as I have said, it's a bit longer. It's a bit longer chapter, so cooperate with me. Let's move on. Before entering into the main section of this chapter, let me give you some basic information. And it's about Ottoman Empire. You must have heard about Ottoman Empire. See, I want to give you just two main information about Ottoman Empire. Ottoman Empire is actually an Islamic run superpower, and it was the longest and mightiest dynasties in the world history, and it ruled over Middle East, Eastern Europe, North Africa, and all for 600 years. There were many provinces which was under Ottoman Empire, and I have listed here some of the countries which were once under Ottoman Empire. These countries have actually broken away from Ottoman Empire and they become independent countries or nation state. And these are some of the countries: Turkey, Greece, Bulgaria, Egypt, Hungary, Macedonia, Romania, Jordan, Palestine, Lebanon, etc. And I want you all to know this particular country, that is Greece. That's why I have given this slide. So keep this in mind. It is actually Islamic run superpower, and it ruled over Eastern Europe and Arabia and all. And Greece was once under Ottoman Empire. In the last video, I have given you the existence of two kinds of ideologies in Europe. One was liberals and other was conservatives. Conservatives were autocratic in nature and liberals were revolutionaries, and conservatives wanted monarchy back while liberals wanted democracy. In the last section, we have seen Treaty of Vienna, which brought back Bourbon dynasty back to France. But do you think liberals have died off at very fast with the coming of monarchy? No. Always there exist revolutionaries. See, even when Bourbon dynasty came back and ruled France, liberals were there. In the last video, we have seen things which was done by conservatives. Here, now, in this section, we can see what the liberals might have done back to conservatives, or what liberals might have done to restore the lost democratic nation, or what did liberals does to overthrow monarchy. As conservative regimes try to consolidate their power, liberalism and nationalism came to be increasingly associated with revolution in many regions of Europe, such as Italian and German states and the provinces of Ottoman Empire, Ireland and Poland. And these revolutions which happened in all these areas which I have mentioned, that is Italy, German states, provinces of Ottoman Empire, these revolutions were led by our liberal nationals. And these liberal nationalists were mainly the people belonging to educated middle class elite. And these educational middle class elite includes professors, school teachers, clerks, members of commercial middle classes. See, as I have said, Greece has been part of Ottoman Empire since 15th century. Something remarkable event actually occurred in the year of 1821. We have already seen some kind of revolutions occurring in Europe. French Revolution, and Napoleon came up, and then came Treaty of Vienna, and many things actually happened. Overthrowing of monarchy, restoring of monarchy, revolutions, democratic, everything. Many things actually happened in Europe. All these things had actually instilled a spark of struggle for independence amongst the Greeks. Greece was under Ottoman Empire, as I've said. From 15th century, they were ruled by Sultan. When they witnessed all these revolutions in Europe, they suddenly felt, not in a sudden way, they felt that we also need independence. There exists a need of revolution. And all the things began in 1821. In 1821, the Greek War of Independence started. And what happened is that Greece was inspired by the revolutions which happened in Europe. And when Greece started fighting for independence in the year of 1821, this event of struggle in turn instilled the nationalistic feeling among educated elite across Europe, and the liberal nationalists of Europe started to fight against a conservative regime. See, actually things happen like this. Greece people were inspired by the revolutions happened in Europe, and Greeks started War of Independence in the year of 1821. And when at that time during 1821, our Europe is under autocratic rule or the conservative regime, and Bourbon dynasty was restored in 1851. And in 1821, Greece started its War of Independence, and this event in turn instilled the nationalistic feeling among the liberal nationalists of Europe. The liberals are going to fight against conservative regime, and let's see what happened after 1821 of Greek War of Independence. When the Greek War of Independence came up, nationalists in Greece got support from other Greeks which were living in exile, and also from many West Europeans who had sympathies for ancient Greek culture. They got Greeks people, they got support from the Greeks which were living in exile, and also from the West European people who had sympathies for ancient Greek culture. Poets and artists, they praised Greece as the cradle of European civilization and mobilized public opinion to support its struggle against a Muslim empire. Here, the Muslim empire meant the Ottoman Empire. The English poet Lord Byron organized funds and later went to fight in war, and he died of fever. And finally, Treaty of Constantinople in 1832 recognized Greece as an independent nation. Please remember the dates. In 1821, the struggle started, and in 1832, with the Treaty of Constantinople, Greece was recognized as an independent nation. Children, this Constantinople was the capital of Ottoman Empire. See, I have said the thing is going like this. Greece witnessed the revolutions in Europe, and they fought for independence in the year of 1821. When Europe witnessed this war, they were again, the liberals of Europe was again instilled with the spirit of nationalism, and first upheaval took place in France in the year of 1830, in the month of July. And this revolution was known as July Revolution, and it happened in France. And a normal question would pop up in your mind: what happened in France after July Revolution? In 1815, with the Treaty of Vienna, Bourbon dynasty came back. And after the July Revolution, Bourbon dynasty was overthrown. See, Bourbon dynasty, which was restored with the Treaty of Vienna, was overthrown with July Revolution. It was, the Bourbon dynasty was headed by King Charles X. After this dynasty was overthrown, he was also overthrown, and liberals installed constitutional monarchy with Louis Philippe at its head. After July Revolution, Bourbon dynasty was overthrown, and Bourbon dynasty was headed by Charles X. He was overthrown, and Louis Philippe was installed by liberals as monarch, but it's not pure monarchy, not the word constitutional monarchy. Constitutional monarchy meant, what is constitutional monarchy? Constitutional monarchy is a system of government in which monarch shares power with constitutionally recognized government. That's the difference between pure monarchy and constitutional monarchy. Here we have a monarch, his name is Louis Philippe. Along with him, or along with this monarch, he share constitutionally organized government is sharing power. Now what? It's not only the monarch who is going to decide about the country, but we have a constitution, and the constitution allocates rest of the government's power to legislature and judiciary. We have judiciary, we have legislature, but in constitutional monarchy there exists a king, but he is not having the whole power. There exists a constitution also. That's the difference between pure monarch and constitutional monarchy. And Metternich remarked, Metternich, please recap, who was Metternich? It's the same Duke Metternich of, who was Metternich? He was the host of Treaty of Vienna. He said, when France sneezes, rest of the Europe catches cold. What did he mean by that? That is, when something actually happened in France, the same wave, the whole Europe will actually sense the wave. Some revolution has actually happened in France, that is called July Revolution in 1821. And it had effect, this July Revolution has had an effect on other European states. That's what Metternich meant by this. Europe, France il endeyle sambhavicha Europe il ellam adu pettana spread down. That's what he meant by this. This July Revolution, what was the after effect of July Revolution of France in Europe? In other part of Europe, what happened is that Belgium broke away from United Kingdom of Netherlands. That's what happened after July Revolution. It sparked an uprising in Brussels, which led to Belgium breaking away from United Kingdom of Netherlands. Belgium was earlier, it was a part of Netherlands. After witnessing this July Revolution, people of there happens to be an uprising in Brussels, which led Belgium broke away from Netherlands, and now on Belgium is going to be an independent nation state. Have a recap of what we have learned today. First was the Greek War of Independence, which happened in the year of 1821. Next was the Treaty of Constantinople in 1832, which made Greece as an independent nation. And next was July Revolution 1830, which happened in France. And these were the three revolutions which we have learned today. And hope you might have understood the lesson. Thank you for watching the video, and there will be assignment attached in your classroom. Please go through that and submit it before due date. Thank you.